Hey, how's it going, everybody? Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com. Welcome to the update for Monday, April 26, 2021. Free play in baseball on this report. We're coming off a real nice Sunday. We went 3-1. We won in baseball with the Brewers, a nice 6-0 win. We won in golf. In fact, we swept a 2-0 card this week at the Zurich Classic. And we also won our third winner of the four games, was a 6-star play in NASCAR. And that was with Eric Amarola over Martin Truex Jr. My NASCAR run now stands at 55-30, going back to May of 2019. All those plays released at DocSports.com. So a real good Sunday at 3-1, but we came this close to being a fantastic Sunday, because I had in soccer a $3 plus 300 underdog on West Brom. And West Brom, if you saw the game, they were leading 2-1. They gave up the game-tying goal in extra time, about 2 minutes into extra time in the second half. And as you know, if you play three-way soccer, a draw is a loss. But 3-1, so close to being an outstanding day. Picking up a plus 300 underdog would have been pretty nice. Here's what we got going for Monday. I do have Major League Baseball. I've got two plays on Monday. My 4-star and 3-star plays in baseball are not only hitting 67% winners on the season, but they're up over $1,700 for $100 per unit bettors. I've got two plays on Monday, and a 4-star leads the way. I've got NBA. We passed on Sunday. We're back in action on Monday. A play that's backed by a 100% winning spot. And cashed a 7-star NHL on Friday. Cashed a 3-star on Saturday. Passed yesterday. But we come back on Monday with an NHL play after passing on Sunday. And we are up almost $5,000 for those wagering just $100 per unit on this current NHL run. So those are the plays for me on Monday. Again, Major League Baseball two plays, NBA one play, NHL one play. Let's look to go 4-0. Free play for today is the battle between the Cubs and the Braves. It'll be Davies and Morton on the mound. And listen, not too long ago, we talked about the Braves potentially riding the ship when their pitching started getting some luck. I mean, they had an ERA of 5.5. They had an XFIP of 3.5. And yesterday was nothing to do with pitching. It was all struggling at the plate. They got completely shut down at the plate, scored no runs, lose the 7-inning doubleheader, and got swept. But now they start a new series. They're hosting an anemic offense in the Chicago Cubs. We went against them yesterday with the Brewers, and they've got a great pitching matchup in this one. However, instead of recommending laying around $1.80, which is where this price sits right now as I cut this video, I'm recommending to lay the runs line with the Braves, which of course is a run and a half, and you can get, I'm looking at my screen now, anywhere from plus $1.10 to plus $1.20 as I cut this video on that run and a half. So that's our suggestion here. And as far as Morton, you know how good he's been. As far as Davies is concerned, well, he got roughed up the last time that he faced the Atlanta Braves, and I expect more of the same here. So listen, yesterday, real bad day at the plate, but at home against right-handers, the Atlanta Braves have been extremely strong. They are 8th in team batting average in this situation. They are 4th in weighted runs created plus. They're also 4th in WOBA. I expect a bounce back here out of the Atlanta Braves, and going to recommend a runs line play. Lay the run and a half with the Braves over the Cubs on Monday. All right, that's going to do it for me for Monday's report. If you like the videos, click on that thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe. I'm Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Let's put Monday in the win column.